Welcome to the wonderful world of downsizing. Downsizing. That's the word we used to use in the olden days for minimalism. Minimalizing, whatever. If you're moving into nomad life for the first time, it's a given that your new space is, it's going to be smaller than your old home. That first leap is what I call the big sort. Moving out of sticks and bricks and into a vehicle, you're going to have to separate what you're going to take forward into your new life from what you're leaving behind with your old life. It's hard. It's life-changing. Make the music loud. Make the music loud. Make the music loud. This is my friend Tim. He's getting his van ready to hit the road full-time. What is the one thing you're not going to be able to bring that you really wish you could bring?
More merch.
Tim is a flea market vendor, so he's got some specific needs in terms of how he's going to use his space. His priority is maximizing the space that's available for sellable merchandise.
So if you had more space, you would just put in more things to sell.
Oh, hell yeah.
Mm-hmm. What is the one thing you're bringing that you just don't feel like you could live without?
Maybe my laptop.
Oh yeah, that makes sense.
It's just that it's a good laptop, you know? I don't know.
Yeah.
It's an older one. It's a Dell that was reconditioned, so it's made really well. It'll hold up in a big van full of stuff falling on it and, you know, moving around and stuff like that, yeah. Yes. I'm going to be bringing all my laptops with me, yeah.
How many laptops do you have?
Let's see, 1, 2, 3. I have 4 laptops.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And they have different uses.
Mm-hmm. Like what? Like what are the different uses?
Well,
Tim starts giving me all the justifications of why he needs to bring 4 laptops into van life. You know, as if he has to explain it to me. He doesn't have to explain it to me.
I have one that looks like it's been through all the wars that there's ever been. And you can get them pretty much anywhere for cheap.
Like you said, you can get them anywhere. So if you needed another one, you could find another one.
Yes, for
right?
Cheap. It's like
yeah.
$50.
So why would you put them in here when you have limited space?
For some reason, I just like them.
Isn't that the real reason you're bringing them all? Because you like them, right?
Yes.
Which you're allowed to do.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Secret is out. You can bring something just because you like it. Tim is leaving next week. He's been shedding stuff for a couple of years.
I actually wanted to do this full-time about 3 years ago. That's when I found Bob Wells' videos and others, of course. And I was inspired.
So he's already whittled his personal belongings down quite a bit.
My landlord is selling the house. There's no set date when this is happening. So basically, I've been sort of gently ushered out.
When I moved into the bus in 2018, I was already living in a very small space. Well, it was inside my store, which was not a small space, but I was living in a little loft. And I didn't have a lot of personal possessions. Well, what I did have was a lot of clothes. An insane amount of clothes. At one point, I counted 112 dresses. I kept them hanging by color. You know, all the purple ones together, all the green ones together. By the time I hit the road, I had whittled that down to 10 dresses. I was a dress person. I still am a dress person. I picked 10 because I figured, you know, that will get me about 2 weeks between visits to the laundromat. I think I might have had like 2 pairs of pants. I don't wear a lot of pants. So flash forward to now. I've actually got 4 pairs of pants now because I'm in the cold. I need pants more. And now I guess I'm having to do what I would call the little big sort or the big little sort. The big sort done a long time ago, but see, I've had some space here to play with here at my mom's. I've expanded, I've accumulated, and I'm up to 24 dresses, I think. Yeah, so I think you see the pattern. The longer I'm in one place, the more dresses appear. So now I need to get that down. So that's one downsize that I have to do. Like Tim, I have decided that I'm going to make money on the road selling at flea markets and swap meets like I do now. Not at the scale that I do now. I don't want to do the big setup and all that stuff. So instead of selling all kinds of things, I want to restrict that to jewelry, sunglasses, maybe a few tchotchkes every now and then, and some postcards, some paper stuff. Not a whole big setup of that stuff. I don't have the space for the bigger stuff. I don't want to set it up anymore, as you know from seeing me at Brimfield. I'm getting rid of most things, but my plan is to fill this dresser with merch, as Tim calls it, and get rid of the stuff that either isn't on point or doesn't physically fit, and I'm cranking through it. when I started in the bus, people would say to me, oh, you should do this or that, and I'd give you more storage space. And I thought, why would I need more storage space? I wasn't even really using up the storage that I had. I didn't bring that much with me. But as you travel, things come up. You see something maybe that another nomad has, and you see how it's enriched or simplified their life, and you say, oh, I need that. And maybe you get stuck in a ditch and you realize that you need some kind of extraction gear, or you have to sleep with your head pointing down a few too many nights and levelers start to seem like more of a priority. Your tent blows away, so you need heavier stakes, right? Your basic kit just kind of grows. And maybe on top of that, maybe you're a collector? I don't know. Like, you know, I know people who, just like Lucy in the Long, Long Trailer, I know people who collect rocks. Rocks are heavy and they take up space. Before you know it, you gotta do another sort. Some of the things I was most adamant about keeping, you know, the things I felt like, oh, these are the important things, I don't even have anymore. My antique perfection heater, for example. I love that thing, but it's big and it didn't get enough use to justify the amount of space, so I sold it. And when I let go of that, I started to reconsider my super cute little stove. Remember my little cute stove? Because for those two items, I needed to keep a huge jug of kerosene lamp oil on hand. So I gave it to Tim because he needs it, and that stuff ain't cheap. Now he gets to worry about how big and heavy it is. And that simplified my solar setup because I was having trouble figuring out where to put certain things. Now I have all that space back because I got rid of three things. So yeah, clearing out is a great way to see what really matters. And those kind of choices definitely are gonna change over time. When I look at something I've been dragging around for a long time, a lot of times my reflexes, you think, well, it was important to me yesterday, it must still be important to me. And that's not really always true. Today, I can hang on to the memory and let go of the thing. But the game is not whoever dies with the least toys wins. You know, sometimes we talk about minimalism so much that it starts to feel that way. The game is actually fitting your big life into a small space. How big of a life can you fit in a small space? It's a challenge. I have to do it. Tim has to do it. If you want in on this nomad thing, you will have to do it. I got some work to do. I don't know about you.
I do have a fantastic steel case chair from the 70s. They just last forever and they're super stylish and really fun. I even thought about taking the passenger seat out and putting that in there in its place. That's how much I like that chair.
Look at this. I'm down to 14 dresses. Oh, I want to give a shout out to November, not the month. I'll give a shout out to the month. Bye, November, December now. But I wanted to give a shout out to November, the person who I got to meet this week. And we had great conversation. It was super fun to see her little shuttle bus. Thank you, November, for connecting. And any of you guys, as I'm traveling across America, I'm hoping that I'm going to get to meet more and more of you. At this point, I don't know when exactly I'm going to be leaving. Still hoping for near the beginning of January, but things are not moving as quickly with the, anyway, you don't need to hear all that. I mean, I can't go everywhere, but I'll go wherever I can.